Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this particular video we will learn the low frequency response of different type of transistor amplifier, that is FET amplifier. As far as FET is concerned, we have many types of FETs, but in this particular syllabus we have to learn the JFET and MOSFET. So either be of MOSFET D type or E type, either be JFET, right? So still we have the same logic, same procedure to follow for low frequency response of FET amplifier as it is. So let us understand the fact that before applying the low frequency response, we have to learn that we are just finding the value of the low cutoff frequency. Once we get the low cutoff frequency, we'll be able to draw the frequency response of the FET amplifier, right? So first of all, we'll have to draw the AC equivalent model for this particular FET amplifier. As this symbol represents, it's a JFET amplifier, but nevertheless we can use MOSFET, D MOSFET, E MOSFET as well. Still we'll be getting the same AC equivalent model. So we'll draw the AC equivalent model first. Considering the fact that in JFET we have infinite input resistance, so we will be getting the VGS here, but open circuit. This is source, this is drain side, and this is gate side. We don't have to disturb the capacitors while doing the performance of low frequency response. So we will draw the rest part of the circuit without disturbing the capacitors as a short circuit. So we will draw this RS. We'll consider that RG is equal to R1 parallel R2. Okay. Then here we'll have to consider the capacitor along with the source resistance. VI and R signal. And here we'll consider small RD, which is the part of the transistor itself, we can say RO, and then the resistor RD, right? Then we can say the capacitor and load resistance RL. This is CC2, this is CC1, and as usual this is CS, that is bypass capacitor. Now in this circuit as well, we have got the three RC network, whereas this is first RC network, this is the second RC network that we'll have to consider, and this is the third RC network that we'll have to consider for contributing the third value of lower cutoff frequency. So we'll take one by one. We'll case one will be for input circuit. So A part will be at input. So if we take at input side, we will be getting, this is capacitor, this is RG, and this is the signal. Okay, and here it is connected to the input. Okay, value is CC1 for the capacitor, this is R signal, and this is obviously connected to the ground. Now again, as I suggest that this is VO and this is VI. If we take this particular circuit network, then I'll get to know that this will form an lower cutoff frequency ke liye particular ratio of parameters in the form of R signal CC1 and RG, right? So whatever frequency, lower cutoff frequency I will be getting, that I'll consider it is as FL1, and that is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi RC. Now question arises, what is R? So R is nothing but, I'll say that ajubajuke resistance, summation of ajubajuke resistance, that is nothing but R signal plus RG. Now you will get to know that ki R signal plus RG is nothing but the resistance R once we do the exact analysis of this particular circuit, considering the fact that capacitor is in series with R signal and resistance RG is in shunt with the input and output, right? So if we follow the procedure of low frequency response one by one and we'll take one particular frequency as the 2 pi RC, then we'll get to know that this R comes out to be R signal plus RG. So we'll not consider that particular part again over here again and again. So that will be a donkey work. So we'll not do donkey work over here. C will be CC1 obviously. And then put the value, get the answer, you will get the value of FL1. Okay. So let's move towards the second part. That is nothing but the output side. So here we will be getting the another RC circuit, whereas I can say that this is nothing but your RD, this was the RD, it was missed out, this is RD, okay. So while doing the analysis for particular capacitor, we'll have to short all the capacitors. So here I can say that this resistance will be redundant and this RO becomes parallel with the RD. I can say that this RD will become in parallel with RO, right? So this RD parallel RO, and this is nothing but the resistance RL. This is your CC2, and I can say that connected to ground. So simple, ajubajuka resistance, I can say that the value of R, rest of the part is same, FL2 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi RC, that is same. We'll have to calculate the value of R. R is nothing but, I can say RD parallel RO plus RL. Question arises, what if we'll have value RO is infinity? Then we don't have to consider the value of RO. As it is, it will be value of RD parallel RO as RD, capital RD only, if RO is equal to infinity. And if RL is not given, then the value will be automatically RD parallel RO, right? So your R is RD parallel RO and plus RL, that will be your value of R. And obviously C is nothing but CC2. So if we put this value C and R over here, we'll be getting the value of FL2, right? Let's move towards the next part, that is C part. When we learn the C part is related to the bypass capacitor. So bypass capacitor is associated with the resistance RE, right? And along with the, I can say that the current source, that is GM into now we'll have to consider the C part, that is related to the bypass capacitor, and you can say that we'll write it over here, bypass capacitor, and your circuit diagram will look like, this is your RS connected with CS, right? Here we will be getting the current source, that is GM into VGS, and obviously here the rest of the circuit that we don't require. Okay, as far as the resistance is concerned, we all know that if we consider the emitter follower, or sorry, source follower, then we'll be get to know that what will be the resistance R? R is nothing but your RS parallel 1 upon GM, and the same value will be getting if we look at look from this particular capacitor into this particular circuit, then we'll get to know that this is nothing but your RS, because this is nothing but your resistance will also become a part of this particular transistor. So that's why this current is flowing into this source resistance, and this value of this R will become RS parallel 1 upon GM. And you just have to put this value of R, that was the crucial part, and rest of the things are very simple. 1 upon 2 pi RC will be getting the value of R as RS parallel 1 upon GM, right? And C is nothing but CS. So this is how we have got the value of FL1, FL2 and FL3, and your lower cutoff frequency is obviously max of FL1, FL2, FL3. Right, so out of three values of lower cutoff frequencies, we'll have to choose exact value of lower cutoff frequency which one is higher side. Okay, so if FL2 is at higher side, we'll have to pick FL2 as lower cutoff frequency and discard FL1 and FL3. Okay, so this is very simple to understand the lower cutoff frequency, lower frequency response of FET amplifier. In few further videos, we will learn the combined part of the two stage frequency response, and then we'll get to know that how the complications becomes more complex. So stay tuned for that, and we'll learn more and more Ekeeda videos, more and more EDC. Learn with me. Thank you so much.